Attention all Corvette fanboys, it's time to iron your jean shorts. Oh, I'm sorry, your jorts. Dust off your New Balance sneakers and dig up your Corvette logoed members only satin jacket and get your gold chains polished. The full specs of the 2023 Z06 were unveiled today. But will it be enough to steal customers from the Dancing Donkey and the Bucking Bull brands? We'll talk about that right after the break. Did you know that the average driver gets 9 traffic tickets in their lifetime? Look, I'll be the first to admit that I've taken maybe a couple of liberties with traffic laws back in the day. And of course, when I got caught, I had to go to court to fight the ticket, which was always a hassle. And each time that I lost my case, it meant big fines, points on my record, and higher insurance premiums. Eventually, I realized that nothing beats having a good attorney argue your case in court. So here's what you do. You download the Off the Record app to your phone and register for an account. And if you get a ticket, simply upload a photo of your ticket into the app and you will be quickly matched with a lawyer in your jurisdiction. Your lawyer will start working your case right away, and in most cases, you'll never have to set foot in a courtroom. Off the Record has a 97% success rate and a 4.9 star rating on Google. And guess what? They even offer a money-back guarantee if they aren't able to reduce the points or keep that ticket fully off your record. Best of all, I've arranged a 10% discount for all of my YouTube viewers, so download the app and register using the referral code FASTLIFE to receive 10% off your first case. I'm gonna confess right now. It's no secret that I've been teasing Corvette owners for decades.
On the last episode,
if they had done this in the Mark V Supra, I would have considered it, despite the small size.
Wow. Corvette took notes though.
Yeah, but it's Corvette. I'll never be that old or never be that hairy. So Corvette's not my cup of tea. My angst was always about the, shall we say, interesting fashion choices that generally followed that audience around and became a globally recognized stereotype. None of that teasing, of course, was aimed at the platform, but more so about the stereotypical Corvette owner. So forgive me my sins. Truth be told, I've long appreciated the Corvettes. Well, some of them. I drove my first Corvette in late 1984, and it was a beast, and I certainly understood the appeal from that very first drive. And over the years, I developed a fondness for the 63 split window, which is still my favorite, and of course, the 67 with the 435 horsepower L71, or better yet, the 16 Vets that got the aluminum-headed version, the L89 engine, right? The next Vet that I drove was a 72 with the LS5 454, but only made 270 horsepower because the SAE changed the way they reported horsepower. But honestly, that car felt poorly built and cheap. But since then, I've driven all of the subsequent models except for the C7. Bang for the buck is the big attraction for these cars, whether or not you like the style, right? With the release, though, of the C8, the world finally got a mid-engine Corvette, something that had been promised or to be coming in the next generation. And we've been hearing this story for more than 5 decades, largely because GM kept making prototypes that went to car shows and wound up on magazine covers saying, will this be the next Corvette, a mid-engine? But when it finally did happen with the C8 and it hit the streets, the praise has been nothing but great on every front. Finally, we got an interior that didn't look like it came from an Avis rental car, and it was married to a sleek, stylish exterior that borrows styling cues from several established brands in the space. I'm talking about the Italians, the British, and the Germans. And as we all know, Chevrolet has offered several versions of the Corvette within each new model, including the Grand Sport, the Z06, and the ZR1, to name a few. We also knew a C8 Z06 was coming, and the rumors indicated that it would make something around 575 to maybe 625 horsepower, and that would be done without the use of a supercharger. But today, the world got the truth. The 2023 Z06 will make 670 horsepower with the flat plane crank V8 that will spin to an ear-shattering 8,600 RPM. And if you go for the Z07 option, GM says that that car will go from 0 to 60 miles per hour in 2.6 seconds. That is McLaren territory. So the lineup looks like this from what we know. The base Vet will make 490 horsepower thereabouts. The Grand Sport will have about 550, and with the hybrid equipment, 650 horsepower. There will also be an E-Ray electric version making about 400 horsepower. And there will be a Zora ZR1, which will be coming and making 1,000 horsepower incorporating hybrid technology. This is keeping with the history of the Z06 nameplate, a name that started as a secret ordering code at Chevrolet dealers as far back as 1963. Back then, it was basically upgraded suspension, brakes, and a 36-gallon gas tank so it could do more laps before making a pit stop, which gave it an advantage. This, of course, to do this for the 2023, it meant developing the highest horsepower naturally aspirated V8 engine ever produced for a production car and somehow still meet stringent emission standards. The LT6 flat plane crank V8 makes sounds that are right up there with the Italian stallion cars. GM went to great lengths to get the exhaust exactly right on the outside and inside in the car for the driver experience. A YouTuber, car spotter Jerome, caught some great footage and sounds in this video and even timed a lap, unofficially of course, at 7 minutes and 12 seconds at the Nürburgring. MSRP on the base model should come in at around $85,000, and allegedly, if you can order one at a dealer, you'll pay the price listed on the invoice. However, it's more likely that some dealers won't take pre-orders at all and will basically sell them to the highest bidders, and of course, add a huge dealer markup like on the window sticker like most dealers do. This is the douchebaggery that keeps me praying that all car dealers will become obsolete, as in my opinion, they add nothing to the transaction. But in my view, this iteration of the Corvette will be groundbreaking, and it has a real genuine chance of attracting customers from the European brands, and I mean that sincerely. The bad thing though is that Corvette loyalists will now be presented with a terrible choice. Do they keep their older Corvettes and their current wardrobe, or do they buy a new Corvette and ditch their jean shorts for chinos, trade in their New Balance sneakers for a pair of Bruno Mays, and put their Corvette branded gold chain up for sale on eBay? What to do? Jokes aside, the C7 and the C8 are seriously legitimate cars, and they are equal to or superior to many of their Italian, British, and German rivals. And as the sun slowly sets on the age of internal combustion engines, General Motors walks into that sunset with its head held high and beaming with pride for what they've accomplished with this car. I can't wait to drive one. Thanks so much, everybody, for watching. We'll see you next time.